Hello, my beautiful Sagittarius. Welcome to the channel. I hope you're doing well. My name is Donna Wilder Hart. This is Irish Donna Tarot, and you are about to get your top secret cross watchers video. Everything you want to know about your person in terms of what they think, they feel, they plan and intend, and what their actions will be. So let's get started with your reading. I want to thank all my beautiful subscribers for all of your likes, your shares, your comments, your subscribes, and welcome to all new visitors. I'm so glad to have you here. Welcome. All right, so let's see what the first card is. Whoa, Sagittarius, you are looking pretty. Look at you. You are single and ready to mingle is what your person thinks of you. They think that they better do something about that if they want to be with you. So they think that you look a little independent for their taste. Look at this. They view you as someone that with a Six of Cups energy, that's a happily ever after, but they have fond memories. They have tenderness in their heart for you. When they think of you, they smile. So they feel as though you are fine as wine, Sagittarius. And you are, right? So we have Virgo energy and we have Scorpio energy. Okay. So let's see. Ooh, Seven of Swords. This is a bit of a problem here. Seven of Swords energy is somebody who is stealing eggs like a snake, okay? So that's their thoughts, that they may have to be dishonest with you to get your attention. This is really undefined right now. The clarifiers will tell the story, because when we look at the Seven of Swords, it can mean several things, but my nickname for it is the Tricky Dick card, that they're willing to do whatever they have to win you, and I don't really like that energy. They see you as being very independent, and they want you. And the Page of Wands says, look at this. They're watching your every move. Look at how big that spyglass is. That's hysterical. Page of Wands are going to throw caution to the winds. I mean, they would hire a private detective if they needed one. They would put a tracker on your car. So, and I am joking. I don't want to throw any bad juju on anybody. It's just a joke. Okay, King of Pentacles in their heart space. This is the daddy and nurturing card, but it's the soft side. It's when somebody really wants to be gentle. They want to cuddle with you. They want to give you gifts. They want to nurture you. This is love. This is Venus. It's Taurus energy, second house. You are everything that they value. You are everything that they want. But Taurus energy is in their heart space, and that is literally the planet of love and the moon card. As a co-ruler of Taurus, meaning that they have really deep emotions for you that make them want to nurture you. All right, the Five of Wands, they feel as though they have competition, and they are going to do, all's fair, that's what it means. Okay, here we go. They have competition. You are playing the field, single as a Pringle and ready to mingle. They have competition, and all's fair in love and war is exactly what this card means, okay? So they're willing to pull out the stops to get to have you. I don't necessarily agree with it at all, depending on what that means. Okay, so we're going to find out more than when we clarify. Let's see, what is their intention? Queen of Wands energy, they want to come towards you. That's fiery Aries energy. They want to seduce you with happiness. They want to show you good times. They want to make you feel, really sexy and good and happy. They're going to fight for you. That's the Aries Queen energy. She knows how to get a conquest, and she knows how to wear a red dress. Let's see, Two of Wands energy. What we have here is your person is at this crossroads, and they need to make a decision about exactly what strategy they're going to use to come into alignment, to win you, to beat the competition. They don't know quite what that strategy is, but let's see if we can find out. Okay. Again, willing to do the work. They're just willing to do the work. This is a person who will refuse to give up until they can walk not one more step, they will not relax. So your person plans on really going sort of to the ends of the earth, so to speak, to win you over. They really, I would say that you'll probably get a bouquet of flowers or, you know, of roses. It looks as though they could be a person who likes to give flowers. And let's see what we have for their actions. The action's a hanged man, so they're taking a hot moment. We see that as Pisces energy. They're a little bit confused as to what to do. The Four of Wands, there we go, look at that. That's a marriage card. You can see this is a couple that's built a foundation very high. So their strategy is to win you over, to do whatever they have to do to sort of love bomb you, is what I think, with this, all this attention, all this love, and prove to you that they're the one that is worthy. Four of Wands energy, Aries energy. They're fighting for you. This is the fight for you card. And look at this. They have a lot of fight in them. Very phallic looking, by the way. But anyway, I digress. But you can really see the couple dancing on the top. I'm not sure if you can see that. Let's see. Dancing on the top of the building, and that's very Rider-Waite. That's a couple dancing at the wedding. I don't know if it shows better there. But anyway, you get the idea. So that is buying a home together, being married, building a foundation, and look at this, the Star card. Hopes and dreams for love coming true. So that is their action. They're going to manifest the dreams. They're going to do that by building a strong foundation with you. As a partner, and they're not quite sure what that looks like yet, but they'll figure it out. They're very intuitive also. So let's see what the clarifiers are for you, Sagittarius. I love this reading. The readings have been so positive. I just love the energy. I think lockdown has taught us a thing or two about love, and that is when you have it, cherish it, and don't let it go anywhere. Make it grow. You know, the Ace of Wands, ooh, they want you. The Ace of Wands is clarifying. They think you look. There is a particular way that you wear your hair. There's something particular about the way you dress that makes this person crazy. Schwingalicious. The Ace of Wands, that is a big wand. All right, so let's see this. When they think of how they're going to make this all work, they're trying to be very strategic. They know that they have to bring a good offer. This person knows absolutely that they need to win you. You will not suffer any fools. They have to also, they know that even though they're willing to pull out the stops and do anything to win you, they also know that they better tell you the truth. Because when we get the Two of Swords energy, this means that you will absolutely sort of, I wouldn't say kick them to the curb, but you will not let them in your life if they do not tell you the truth. So when they pull out the stops, they have to be very strategic. They have to be very, very clever about the way that they come towards you, because they see that there's a lot of competition around you for your attention. Okay, why is the Page of Wands here? They are really snooping on you. That's Four of Swords. Sag. They feel that they've seen something that wounds them. This person feels as though when they look at your social media, perhaps, or they're trying to watch you, that you may already be in a relationship. But here they're determined. They feel as though, hey, what's the competition? The competition has nothing on me. The competition is, I will love bomb this person. I know how to do it. I have the goods. So it really says that this person is totally all about winning your love, about showing you affection, about fighting for you. They are willing to fight for you. The chess moves tell me that they see you as a person who has a lot of love interests, and they have to be very witty. They have to be very smart, and they have to be very clever about how they're going to be the winner, okay? They have to get in there sort of under camouflage and win you, and sort of sneakily, stealthily win your heart, even though other people are in there. Look at hopes and dreams for love coming true. this person is not going to be put aside. They are definitely going to make it very difficult for you to say no. They're very invested in the relationship. Now, when I get the Three of Cups, they're going to be very clever, because what they're going to do most likely is invite you and your friends out to do things so that they're not really making you uncomfortable. So it's very interesting. They could have a party and invite friends, all definitely strategically sort of geared to seeing you and being around you. Judgment card says that when we have the Queen of Wands, which we have twice, this person knows that they have to come at you the right way. Because if they lie to you, if they do anything that you don't like, you will release them. You will draw a judgment on them. So though they're going to pull out the stops, though they'll do everything they can to win, they still have to play within the parameters of the truth and have integrity with you, or else you will not be interested. It does look like at some point you probably close this person out. I feel as though for some of you, you might not have spoken to this person for a while, and or you're about to do it, and they're freaking out. Look at this person. They're like crying in front of the door, even though there's a big key, even though it's pretty obvious that there's, you know, a lock right there. You know, this really shows that your person is, they are planning and intending to do the work. They're not quite sure exactly whether. They're really fearful. That's what I'm getting. They're kind of fearful, but they're willing. They have fire in their belly for you, Sagittarius energy. And your outcome and their actions are undeniable here. We get the Hanged Man as they ponder things. They dream about you. Oh my gosh, this is daydreaming about you. And happily ever after. That is what they are. The actions they're going to take are to win your heart. And look at this. So you've got two of the best marriage cards, two of the happiest cards in the deck. This person is going to take actions. We are on their actions to manifest love, a spiritual, beautiful love that's honest and clear and kind and very, very beautiful. And we see it's, again, happily ever after. This is a trifecta of happiness, my friends. Your person is going to fight they're just going to fight till they get it. All right. Sag, thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your likes, subscribes, shares. Sending you love. Bye-bye.